Good evening. It is so nice to actually see 3D faces in front of me. I am very happy about that. Welcome to Listen Up. Welcome to Artichoke Music, those of you that are here. And welcome to all of our Portland Radio Project listeners that are tuning in on KSFL LP 99.1 FM, or they're streaming us at prp.fm, because tonight's Listen Up festivities are being streamed for the world to hear. The world. Say hi, Mom. I'm on the radio.
Hi, Mom.
All right, I am Veronica Bazzesti. I am from Portland Radio Project. I would like to start things off by thanking everybody at Artichoke Music for partnering up with us and taking this opportunity to help us empower our local music community. When we decided to put this series together, our hope and focus was A, supporting the local music community, but then we kind of dove in a little bit deeper. Us gals have had kind of a tough year, right? Yeah. So we decided we really wanted to hand the microphone over to some really strong female voices. And that's how we do it. Okay, before I introduce this fabulous lady, she and I go way back, by the way. Way back. Okay, this restroom off limits. Go around, hold it, or go around. That's A. Make sure that you go grab yourself a little drink. There's beer, wine. Tip your bartender, of course. There's nibbles. If you're listening from home, go in the kitchen. Get a beer, get some wine, get a nibble. Yeah. Tip your husband. I don't know what you need to do. Cell phones off, please, if you don't mind. And let's get this party started. We have got two amazing performers. We're starting things off with this fabulous gal next to me, Michele Van Kleef. She's the best. She used to be a part of Portland Radio Project, but actually she still kind of is because we play her all the time.
Aww.
She is in the throes of recording some new music, which we are very excited to hear. Are we going to hear any of it tonight?
Yes.
Okay, good. Okay, yes. Good. I like it.
You are.
And by the way, both of our fabulous performers, Michele and our performer that's coming up a little bit later, Gina DeNoble, have some merchandise that is out in the front that you can pick up. So if you hear something you love, go support our local artists, okay? Without further ado, Michele Van Kleef.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It is a pleasure to be here at Artichoke Music. Now, I have been around the Portland scene, I guess, since the 90s. Long time. But I played it. Oh, right. I was 5 years old. But anyway, just kidding. Anyway, this is my first time ever playing at Artichoke Music. And I'm so happy because I've always known about it and I've always wanted to play here. So here I am. Yay! My first time. and yes, I did used to have my own show at Portland Radio Project. I do miss it. I would love to do that again someday. We'll see. Who knows? Monday Music Muse with Michele Van Kleef. Oh, I still got it. Anyways, yes, glad to be here. I'm going to start off with a song that I wrote quite a few years ago called Willing. And this tune was actually placed in the movie trailer. The movie was called Walk the Line. It was about Johnny Cash. Yeah. And it was pretty funny. I was living in Seattle at the time. I was in the bathroom and the trailer came on the TV. I freaked out. I had to run out into the living room and go listen. If you're willing to try, I might be willing to lie. I might be willing to sacrifice. If you're willing to stay, I might be willing to play. My strength beginning to fray. If you are willing, but I'm not willing to buy into lying, I guess my willingness has taken me by surprise.
What began as just fun has set me feeling fine and set me up with a dry drink. Never stop.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. Let's see. So one of my faults is I never ever really make a set list. So we just kind of go with the fly by the seat of our pants type of thing. But this song I wrote, well, I wrote this one about my ex. Mm-hmm. The story about him deciding to go to L.A. for a summer and trying to shop a screenplay. And then me realizing while he was gone, yep, this is better. So, anyway, yeah.
He's heading down south to L.A. with skill, a little luck in a screenplay. Says he's not really searching for fame, but maybe a chance to make a name. Don't fall away, just fall away. She's ever known, flying high across the sky where the birds have never flown, reaching for that raging royal crown. Watch your back, don't fall down, don't fall away, don't fall away from me, don't fall away from me, just
just fall away, fall.
And his co-worker said, they say, can you believe he's leaving us? Will he remember me when he's famous? Hold on, wait a sec, hurry up and write a check. Get back to zero, be a hero. Face your pain. Don't fall away. Don't fall away from me. Don't fall away. Don't fall away from me. Just fall away. Fall. Just fall away.
Thank you. Thank you. And fall away he did. All right. Gosh, such a long period of time to write stuff and who I wrote them all about. So that was a long time ago. I feel like doing one. This one. Yeah, I'm going to do this one. This is a song about having one of those days, which I think we've all had. And, you know. It's just like, oh. But it starts out with the beautiful, you know, the smell of a beautiful day. And it's just the most, that spring kind of feeling, which, of course, we're nowhere near right now. But hold on 1 second here. Got to make sure this doesn't sound good. All right, so this is called One of Those Days.
Drunk off the smell of a beautiful day. Have you had a clumsy day? Have you ever had just one of those days? I lay wide awake at night as my mind finds fault with time. All too soon tomorrow shows with its lights and noise. Gotta go. In love with the colors of the words, incited, in tune with the systems of the world, senses
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. At one point or another, I had this friend of mine, a very close girlfriend of mine, she was very concerned about, she thought she had heart troubles, like physically, and went to doctors and stuff. Nothing was actually wrong. My thought is she just was very upset and had a broken heart and was not in a good situation at home. And turns out that is what happened way later, several years later. But anyways, this is a song I wrote about her, and it's called Paint You Red.
Buildings creaking in the wind, stars covered up by clouds, city lights twinkling instead, running scared from foreign sounds, wrapped around this wild, wild world. While she can't forget, wrapped around you like a girl, whose strong fight will paint you red. Blinking colors, white and red, feet firmly planted on the ground, pretty green, fighting for life, she won't give in to what she's found, wrapped around this wild, wild world, wound so tight, she can't forget. Around you like a girl whose strong fight will paint you red. Sweet taste, warm cup of coffee in her hands, sorting through the paper stacks, living each day one by one, thinking for once, well, maybe life is fun. Wrapped around this wild, wild world, wound so tight she can't forget, wrapped around you like a girl, strong fight will paint you red, wrapped around this wild, wild world, wound so tight she can't forget, wrapped around you like a girl, whose strong fight will paint you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All right, everybody doing good? Okay, good. All right, the next one I'm going to do is a little song I call Here We Go Again. And it's kind of funny. I didn't know that there was several Here I Go Agains in the world. When I wrote, you know, and I came up with my title, I had no idea. No, it's not like White Snake or something, right?
Here I go again.
It's not that. It's so different. I should call it something else, but oh well.
That's okay.
It's out there now. It's too late. So this is kind of a tune about, all right, anyone in a long-term relationship, you have the same argument several times over and over again. Oh, and you're just like, oh God, here we go again. Really?
Mm-hmm. kind enough to pretend. You're not asking that again. It used to be so easy to bend. Here we go again. Here we go again under the night sky. Here we go again, watching the day. Have I lost something inside? Is it caged identity or drowning pride? This vapid heart won't flow with the tide. What is on the other side? I don't want. Perfectly wrapped in convention. And I don't want to live a prisoner of expectation. Here we go again under the night sky. Here we go again, watching the days go by. Times are changing on us again. I'm too tired to pretend. It's too easy to give up in the end. Here I go.
Thank you very much.
All right. Now, I don't know if you can tell with the hair and the jacket, but my t-shirt says Joni, 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 Joni. I am a huge Joni Mitchell fan. And oh my God, she is going to be performing an actual concert. Did you guys hear it? Today is the day that it, I think they announced it today. Oh my God. Yeah, I think at the Gorge, right? The Gorge at George Washington. Right? Yeah, with Brandi Carlile, but I think she's going to actually headline one night. I just can't even believe it. I know. Anyway. I guess we're okay. I thought that one was out. So anyways, I wrote this song about her. I would love for her to somehow hear it. So if anyone has a connection, please, you know, talk to me. I'll say that for the rest of my life. So this song is, it's called Your Own Way, because she did things totally her own way. She still does. Bless her heart. Anyway, album Blue is my favorite. The song Case of You, I do that one as well. I won't be doing that tonight because, you know, I'm trying to do originals here. But I may nod to one of her songs in the middle of this one. You probably will catch.
watch that. Oh, and also I should mention, the thing that was most interesting, one of the most interesting things, is that she did not go to Woodstock. She was not there. She had a TV show appearance the next morning, and her manager was like, no, we'll never get you out of there fast enough. So she writes the song Woodstock, was not there, but watched footage on TV. And it, I mean, that's just hilarious and amazing to me. So.
Blue brought me to tears. A case of you fights my fears. You didn't like the big crowds, but you told your stories out loud. You speak the truth about love, sing like the angels above. Didn't know what you would become. Everyone loves you and your song. You chose your own way in your own head. You stay. Missed the biggest festival and wrote the song telling it all. You speak the truth about love, sing like the angels above. Didn't know what you would become. Everyone loves you and your song. Came upon a child of God. He was walking along the road, and I asked him, where are you going? And this he told me, I'm going on down to Yasker's farm to join in a rock and roll band. I'm gonna camp out on the land. I'm gonna get my by the time we got to Woodstock, we were 500,000 strong, and everywhere there was song and celebration. And I dreamed I saw the bombers riding shotgun in the sky. They were turning into butterflies above our nation. We are stardust, we are golden, and we've got to get ourselves back to the garden. Went home to Canada for peace and quiet, quiet thought. Realized you're an urban girl, so back to California's crazy world. You speak the truth about love. Sing like the angels above. Didn't know what you would become. Everyone loves you. And you speak the truth about love. Sing like the angels above. Didn't know what you would become. Everyone loves you. And your song.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, I think I have about two-ish songs left for you. Okay, one of them is one of my, somewhat newer song, I suppose. It's called, well, that's another problem. I think it really needs to be changed, its name. I originally called it Lose a Little, but it probably should be called When Will It End? Makes way more sense. And I think, can't use a pick on this one. So I wrote this quite a while ago now. Unfortunately, when there were so many school shootings starting, when that began, that's when I wrote this. And I was just so disheartened. And I'm like, my God, when will it end? And it's just still going. I just can't believe it. So also, though, I wrote a new verse for the last verse. I changed it since the original. And that was something I wrote during quarantine because it just seemed, it was also, when will it end, you know? Remember that feeling of, my gosh, are we ever going to get back to anything somewhat normal? So that's what this is all about. It's kind of a sad song, sorry. But
shortness of breath, long deep sighs, underneath it all a growing demise. Read the signs, please advise. Realize, when will it end? When will it? Lose a little of your soul. Another school has been shut up today. The same tragedy, sad, sad family. Gun control, or people control, who's to say anyway? When will it end? When will it end? Lose a little of your soul. When will it end? When will it end? Looking for a little bit of hope. When will it end? And every time we're a little more desensitized, what should we do? What should we say? Bow your head now. Shall we pray? Distance, do what you're told. Don't spread it. Pray you don't get it. We're all asking for help. use a little of your soul. When will it end? When will it end? Looking for a little bit of hope. When will it end?
Thank you. Thanks so much. It's a tough song to sing, actually. Thank you. It's not exactly the most uplifting one, but you know, sometimes that's how it is. And songwriting, it just, honestly, I feel like I write the most when I'm really, really sad. So, interestingly enough, though, this next tune is called Radiate Love, because at some point or another, things were starting to turn. The tides were turning, the world was turning, the United States was turning, everything was turning. And I wrote this tune to kind of, I don't know, kind of as an answer to that last one, I think. Morning's free. Just be, the weight's been lifted for you and me. I've been down for far too long, and now I wonder what my eyes will see. Forgiving is free, but not so easy. Letting go, it's tricky, hard for me. But time keeps moving down the track. You never know what round that corner will be. Radiate love. It's time to take leave from this push and shove. So take a stand and rise above. Radiate. Coaster, crazy upside down, eagerly awaiting, anticipating one departure, one arrival. Prepare yourself for great new beginnings. Radiate love. It's time to take leave from this push and shove. So take a stand and rise above. Radiate love. Look ahead, a future bright. Find your own way to fight. Fight for good, fight for all. Equality is worth the trip and fall. Look ahead, a future bright. Find your own way to fight. Radiate love. It's time to take leave from this push and shove. So take a stand and rise above. Radiate love. Radiate love. Radiate love. Thank you. Thank you so much. I think I'm going to do just this one more song for you, and then we're going to, I think we, do we take a small break? I don't know. I don't really know what we're doing. Okay, we can flow. I mean, I have plenty more songs, but we must also get Gina DeNoble up here. So this is my last one, I think. It's called Snow, and I lived in Seattle for 12 years, And in that time, there was one particular rainy season that it was literally like, I don't know, 89 days straight of rain. But 89 didn't work for my song, so I made it 88. But really, the song is more about telling my friend that, you know, sometimes it's okay to just not have a plan every single day of the week. You know, it's okay to be at home, just chill out. I don't know, I love doing that.
You gotta take into account opportunity is here and now, and there's nobody around to show you how. So much snow in the mountains, 88 straight days of rain. Won't you take time for yourself before you get on that train? Can't you just let each day happen as it does? And later we can talk about how it was. So much snow in the mountains, 88 straight days of rain. Won't you take time for yourself before you get on that train? 'Cause if you try too hard, you won't get that far. So much snow in the mountains, 88 straight days of rain. Won't you take time for yourself before you get on that train? Gotta take into account opportunity is here and now.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, PRP, for having me. Artichoke Music, thank you for having me.
By the way, Joni texted she loved the song.
Oh, perfect.
She did.
You could just see her.
Michele Van Kleef, everyone.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
She needs another round. You have something very special going on November 2nd.
Oh,
why don't
yes.
you tell everybody about
That's
that?
That's true. I do. So I was in this band in the 90s called Kolobo. And Kolobo toured a lot and became, you know, pretty popular at the time. There was this great little place called Locals Only, that used to sell, you know, CDs and records and stuff. And,
what are those?
I know. And Kolobo was like on their top three selling list for ever.
Wow.
It was really cute. Yeah, it was great. But anyway, Coloba was really successful. We were one of the bands in the 90s in Portland and toured a ton. And we are, well, we did one reunion show, like little mini tour, 10 years ago, 2012, October of 2012. But this coming November 2nd, we are reconvening. It's a miracle. And we are playing for, it's a benefit show that Jerry Joseph of Jerry Joseph and the Jack Mormons, he is putting on, and he asked a whole bunch of bands from the 90s to come back together and raise money for, it's a the wife of somebody in the band who had a heart transplant, and we're trying to raise money for that family. And anyway, so great reason to come together, but I mean, 9 Days Wonder, the Renegade Saints, Little Women, Colobo, and I mean, there's a few more I can't think of at the moment, but it is going to be a fun night at Alberta Rose Theater. Yeah. Tickets are online under Alberta Rose Theater's website. You can find them there, but should be a blast.
Oh, the 90s are alive in Portland.
The 90s are never going to die.
Oh, get that lip liner out. Oh, yeah. I love it.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to wear. I don't know.
Oh, Michele, thank you so much.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank
one
you.
One more round.
My pleasure.
One more round.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, how is everybody doing? Oh, that's so great. I can kind of see you guys. You look pretty happy. I think that's good because there's drinks. Because there's drinks. Yeah, I get it. So to all of our Portland Radio Project listeners that are streaming us at prp.fm or tuning us in at 99.1 FM, hello. Happy you are still with us. Gina DeNoble is coming up next. I hope she will start making her way up to the stage because I got a couple things to say, and then the stage is all hers. Everybody here at Artichoke Music, thank you, of course, for being here. We're so thankful that you all came out in... Michele sang about 88 days of rain. We got one day of rain, and I'm already aggravated. I do not know about anybody else, but no one can drive. Oy vey. I'll leave it at an oy vey. I mentioned earlier about Portland Radio Project and our mission to support local music. I don't know if you guys know this, but we play a local artist every 15 minutes. When we are here out in the community and able to support the venues that support a lot of local bands, we really get to appreciate our music community. And we can't do what we do and put on events like this and showcases and feature these amazing women without your support. So all of you listening at home, streaming, listen up from Artichoke Music and PRP, and all of you listening at home and everyone here, if you would like to help us continue to support the local music community, you can go to prp.fm and click that big red heart. Or you can wait until November 1st, because we are in Willamette Week's Give Guide again this year. It's a huge fundraising platform. Last year, Give Guide, all nonprofits managed to raise over $7.5 million. That speaks a lot to how many amazing nonprofits are here in the Portland area and all of Oregon, actually. So we are a part of it this year again, November 1st through December 31st. Any donation that comes our way through GiveGuide not only supports what Portland Radio Project does, but it supports the nonprofit community and artists like this little lady standing right here. Gina DeNoble, hello.
Hi, how are you?
She kind of stalked me a little bit to get up on this stage tonight. Anyway. But she took a little bit of a break from music. We are really, really very glad that she is back and that this stage, thank you again to Artichoke Music, is where she is going to be right now. I mean, I'm stoked. I'm really stoked.
Thank you.
Everybody, welcome Gina DeNoble.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, Veronica. Yes, I am networking my behind off as a newcomer to the kind of Portland area, and we're all kind of thawing out after the pandemic, and I was thrilled to be offered the opportunity to sing for you guys tonight, kind of as my return to build gigging. Thank you. Most of the songs you'll hear tonight, for me, I wrote between the ages of 18 and 21. So if the lyrics sound like they were written by an angsty post-adolescent, it's because they were. And then I recorded my one and only album when I was 23 in 2007, and shortly thereafter injured my voice. Didn't have the resources or the wherewithal to rehabilitate at that time, but I spent the last 2 years kind of getting everything back in shape. So without further ado, my first song is called Full Wine People, and it's a song about new young love. New young. Mulligan, I've recently just started capoing this song to better accommodate my rehabilitated voice, so just false start. Here we go again. Different key. There we go. I climbed in after you turned out the light and comfort swept over me. I'm finding that something just feels right when you just let it be. When something blindsides you on a random Tuesday afternoon, when in hindsight you did a what you never intended to. Yeah, I left your kisses on my back all day long. I feel their sweet caress even as I sing this song. Two empty wine bottles top the table by the window, yeah. Two full wine people top the bed. Two full wine people top the bed. Mm-hmm. Do we begin? Is that what this is here? Simple, sweet, and free. If I let you in, you might leave hurt in tears. The risk is worth the fee. Uncomplicated ways make for a friendship that really stays. Honesty yields black and white avoid the many shades of gray. Yeah, I left your kisses on my back all day long. And I feel their sweet caress even as I sing this song. Two empty wine bottles top the table by the window, yeah. Two full wine people top the bed. Two full wine people top the bed. Two for one people top the bed. Bed, yeah. No, no, no. No, no, no. No, no. No, no, no. Your kisses on my back all day long. I feel their sweet caress even as I sing this song. Two empty wine bottles top the table by the window, yeah. Two full wine people top the bed. Two full wine people top. Two for one people top the bed, bed, yeah. Thank you. Swinging for the fences. Okay. So. My process. Okay. So, this next song is about that same relationship, not at the beginning, at the point where you realize it's gonna end badly, but until then, it's gonna be awesome. Okay.
Time, the worse the heartbreak. But the view from up here is amazing. As I climbed to the tallest peak in the range, broke the bank and built it all. I'm strapped in for the duration of this ride. Keep all hands and feet inside. Altitude makes me high, and it'll be my demise. My money buys thrills at a look, I like chips on the table, yeah. I won't be surprised if you don't know what you got till it's gone. The view from up here's amazing. No, no, no. The view from up here's amazing. No, no, no. Feel and seem so right. For the first time, I feel I've something to lose. Yeah, baby, you make me so, so high. And the view from up here's amazing. As I climbed to the tallest peak in the range, broke the bank. Of this ride, keep our hands and feet inside. Altitude makes me high, and it'll be my demise. My money buys thrills that I look like chips on the table. Yeah, I won't be surprised if you don't know what you got till it's gone. The view from up here's amazing. No, no, no. View from up here's amazing.
So most of my young songwriting was very muse-based. So I drew a lot of inspiration from when you're young and infatuated with someone. but then around the age of 19, I started meditating. And I was living very close to nature, and I got some clarity. And so these next two songs are from that period of creativity.
I speak it. and I pay my dues. And I try to see things from many points of view. My soul is happy now, and I wish I could fly. Honestly, I'm a little scared to die. I make mistakes, that's what it takes. My soul is human now. And I sing a melody, and I paint what I see, and I make love creatively. My soul is artful now, and I stretch my muscles every day, and I take the time to play. Oh, I relax and always mean what I say. My soul is peaceful now. And I tell my friends that I love them. And I tell my men I'm thinking of them. If I kiss and tell, it just means you've done oh well. No, my soul is loved right now. My soul is human. My soul is peaceful, oh, somehow. No, my soul is happy now.
Thank you. I appreciated that. Extra clap. That means very much. Very good enthusiasm. Okay. Okay. As promised, another song from the Clarity period. The Clarity collection, not the Infatuation collection. I tune for y'all's benefit. Sorry about that last song, might have been going out. Oopsie, where am I? It's been a while. I'm learning back the ropes. Okay, did I make it go out now? What do you guys think? Yeah. Pull the audience? Sounds good. Okay. Thank you. Got some musicians in here. You'll tell me the truth. Okay. Wish I could bottle this day. Find a way to make the sunshine stay, stay, stay. I'd put it in a flask and take a nip every time. I wish to bask.
tired, release its rays. Every single time the skies were gray, gray, gray. Never wanna be gray. Wish I could bottle this day. Find a way to make the clear sky stay, stay, stay. I'd put them in a canteen, preserve the serene, clear up the obscurity with lucidity and transparency. Now it's clear to me. Wish I could see your face. Wish I could bathe in your eyes. Wish I could be your grace. Wish I could be the one who stands by your side, by your side forever. With your eyes so blue and your grace so kind and your life so full and your peace of
you guys so much for just listening intently and caring and being here, and thank you.
Not hard.
What's that?
It's not hard.
Oh, cool. Good feedback. Now you can tell that I'm still analog in my process. I have not graduated to tablet territory. This is how I used to do things in the early millennium, and that's what's comfortable, so we're still doing that. Anyway, this next song, I'll try and make long story short. When I was in high school, I found this old National Geographic from, like, maybe 1969, and it had a story in it about a then 16-year-old boy who sailed around the world solo. Yeah, and I became obsessed with, I carried this magazine around, my 17-year-old self, just like had it in my backpack. And I was obsessed with the story, partly because he was super cute, but also because he fell in love on his journey, and he did all these cool things, and he had a motorcycle on his boat, and like all this stuff. So, of course, 17-year-old me in 2002 was obsessed with this 16-year-old kid in 1960-something. Anyway, I go to college and I meet this present my age young man who said he wanted to buy a sailboat and sail around the world. And that sounded great. So this song is the result of that. He never did that, and I never went with him, but a girl can dream. Thank you.
can I sail around the world with you? I know you want to too. Nothing but the wind to guide us, trusting only what we feel inside us. Off into the wild blue yonder, off into the sunset. Right now is the time of our lives, no what ifs and no regrets yet. Sail around the world with you. I know you want to too. Nothing but the wind to guide us, trusting only what we feel inside us. I wanna be your right hand man, I wanna be your first mate. But the moment that we hit a land, we're tangled up in a steamy state. We'd fish, we'd eat, we'd love, we'd sleep, we'd laugh, we'd think, we'd play and we'd drink, we'd sail the seas, bail on reality. Yeah, we'd live our lives staring in each other's eyes. Yeah. No.
Two more. Does that sound like the right timing? Cool. So this next one is the first song I have written in 14 years. It came out this summer, and it's a collection of stories that are not mine, but that I wanted to give a voice to. And the little bit of backstory here is, during my hiatus, I went back to university and I finished 2 degrees in psychology. And after undergrad, the very first job that I took was as a professional victim advocate. So, like Michele, my second to last song is going to be a little bit about heavy subject matter, but important to give a voice to these issues. And yeah, and through, you know, music is a great way to hold people's attention and deliver the messages. So in any case, these are a collection of voices, women's voices. Obviously, all genders experience intimate partner violence, but my caseload was almost entirely women. And these are the voices that have kind of rattled around in my head for the past 10 years since I had that job. And the larger purpose of this song, I hope, will be to specifically dismantle the kind of harmful rhetoric around the sentiment, why doesn't she just leave? After working that job and being like waist deep with these women in the complexities of these situations, that sentiment and that statement has just really been very troublesome to me every time I hear it. So I wrote this song, or rather it came out, and hopefully it will serve its intended purpose. So thank you for bearing with a little bit of a heavier topic for a moment. What about my house? He pays all of my bills. I'm a loyal spouse, but his looks, they give me chills. What about my car? He owns it in his name. I won't get far. It's all my fault and I'm to blame. He doesn't hurt the kids, he's never hit me with his hand. This isn't who he really is. He's a kind and decent man. We were married 15 years before it ever came to blows. My daughter, she adores him, only dad she's ever known. To the shelter. She was mine before I knew him, and these awful cards were dealt her. Sad eyes look right through me, but I am paralyzed in place. Oh, how I wish you knew me, with no scars upon my face. He doesn't hurt the kids, he's never hit me with his hand. This isn't who he really is. He's a kind and decent man. We were married 15 years before it ever came to blows. My daughter, she adores him, only dad she's ever known. One step behind, filled with humiliated rage. I fear one day he'll kill me. He's told me just as much. I'll save pennies from the grocery change until I have enough. I'm sorry, not an easy song to sing and not an easy song to hear, but like I said, these voices have just been echoing in my head for a decade, and it's like they need to come out. Other people need to know. Thank you all for entertaining that, listening to that. And that's the first time that song's ever been performed by performed for anyone other than my mom. Hi, mom, by the way, and my voice teacher. So, thank you.
Your voice teacher did pretty well.
I'll tell her name is Dr. Kari Reagan. Shout out to her up in Seattle at the University of Washington. So tell your friends, she's amazing. Okay, so my last song, bringing back up the mood a little bit. This is a song I wrote when I was 18 years old. I was living in Alaska at the time because I started college at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. Shout out to Michael. Yeah, what up? Need to talk about that someday. But I grew up around Mount Rainier up in Washington, and I was feeling really homesick, and so I'd come home and be like, I'm staying here in Washington forever now, and then I'd get homesick for Alaska, and I'd drive back up there, and then it was a cycle. It was a journey and a process for about 4 years, driving through Canada. I took the ferry one time, and it was just an amazing time period of adventure. And so this song is the title track to my album, and it's called Wanderer's Paradise. Let's see. Oops, see tuning. A little better. Okay. Okay, thank you. As I wander to the unknown, and in the crisp evening air, as the snowbirds take a wing, I see my breath as I sing. 'Cause here on the mountain it's a different kind of life, hemmed in by wilderness and carefree strife. Here on the mountain we by a different set of rules, we make our own way and seek our own truths. You better hurry up here, boy, and get a slice of this wanderer's paradise. Something about you out this night, and I hope this mountain will stay and be my rock, my symbol of freedom, yet my lighthouse dark. And I can come back here someday when I'm old and gray, live out my years where my soul has stayed. 'Cause here on the mountain it's a different kind of life, hemmed in by wilderness and carefree strife. Here on the mountain we live by a different set of rules. We make our own way and seek our own truths. You better hurry up here, boy, and get a slice of this wanderer's paradise.
and perhaps I'll come back as lichen, laurel or dew, or a snowflake in a glacial milieu. Or I'll come back as that voice that floats on the wind. Either way, I'm on my mountain again, yeah. 'Cause here on the mountain, it's a different kind of life, hemmed in by wilderness and carefree strife. Here on the mountain, we live by a different set of rules. We make our own way and speak our own truth. Better hurry up here, boy, and get a slice of this wanderer's paradise. You better hurry up here, boy, and get a slice of this wanderer's paradise. You better hurry up here, boy, and get a slice of this wanderer's, this wanderer's, this wanderer's, of this wanderer's, of this wanderer's, of this wanderer's, of this wanderer's paradise.
Thank you guys so much. I want to say just some thank yous, if I can, really quick. My mom couldn't be here tonight, but she is my biggest supporter, like literally, and I just want to thank her very publicly for everything she's done to help me get back to doing what I love. And thank you to Portland Radio Project and Veronica. Thank you to Artichoke and Shelley, the booking on Artichoke side. Thank you to Michael and Gary, who are doing the sound and video. They are so experienced and talented at that, and I'm learning from them, and thank you to them. And thanks to Briggs, he's tending bar, tip him, please, and thanks to you all for this. Thank you.
Well, and thank you, Gina. Do not stay away so long next time, okay?
I promise.
Yeah. Yeah, don't stay away too long at all. We loved it. Gina DeNoble. And another quick thanks and a round of applause, please, for Michele Van Kleef. Our next Listen Up series is going to be November 11th. Lee Jones and Sessa Fox are going to be our entertainers that evening. Looking forward to that. But do not wait until November 11th to get yourself back to Cafe Artichoke. Artichokemusic.org. They got loads of great shows coming up. Support local venues. It's really important. All of you that are here right now doing that, thank you so much. Everybody that is at home listening on Portland Radio Project, thank you. And we really appreciate you tuning in. Learn more about Michele Van Kleef, Gina DeNoble, and of course Portland Radio Project. You can go to prp.fm. I'll have some connectivity to both of these amazing performers, so that you can show them a little love. Why not, right? And of course, you can show Portland Radio Project a little love, that big red heart. Yeah, that's it. All right, thanks to everybody. Thanks to Artichoke Music. And yes, you said it all so well, Gina. I'm not even going to bother repeating it. Thank you. You know how wonderful you all are. Have a great night.